Well, well, well. What do we have here? Sorry, that was my Billy Butcher impression. What's up, guys? I'm Dean, and welcome back to my channel, where today I have a very exciting video for you guys. If you're not aware, on June 3rd, which for me is tomorrow, and for you guys should be today, the new season of The Boys started. The Amazon Prime superhero show, my favourite TV show ever. 3 episodes out. I'll be talking about those episodes at the end of this video, but for now, I've got something more exciting to talk about, if that's even possible. Amazon Prime has been kind enough to invite me to their immersive experience in London called The Boys Get the V. I would like to quickly say I'm not being paid for this at all. I do genuinely love The Boys. It's probably my favourite TV show ever, and I've just been invited to this for free and gonna have a lot of fun there. So yeah, I'm gonna film how it goes and let you guys know. I'm not 100% sure what's gonna happen, but me and a friend are gonna go in there with a group of 14 or so people and get some Compound V to give it to the boys. And some of the stuff on the website has been worrying me. For example, the content warning says it contains scenes of everything: swearing, violence, blood of a graphic nature, sexual scenes, death, dying, disaster. You name it, we got it. So if you're easily offended, F off. Like, that's a bit worrying. Another worrying bit is where it says, what should I wear? It says, you might get bloody, so don't wear your best and you might have to run. So I'd leave the stilettos at home. Whose blood am I going to get on me? This is going to be crazy. So about what we're actually doing, the details are a little light. We have a briefing here recorded by Billy Butcher.
All right, mate. I ain't going to piss you about. I need your help. The cunts at Vought are trying to spread their unholy shite right here, dear old Blighty. Now, French has done some digging and discovered Britain's very own foreign fucking secretary has been fucking about at a Vought facility in the East End. She's only gone bought in a big fat fucking shipment of Compound V, but it ain't V as we know it. This shit'll let you hard on Yui's morning glory and last about as long. It's called Temp V, and it'll turn you into a soup for 24 hours. Now, fuck knows why they're cooking up this shite, but obviously, Vought don't want us to get our hands on it, because it might just level the fucking playing field. Now, me and the boys have managed to get your security clearance to Vought's London office, and I need you to go in there and nick us a sample of Temp V. We're already running a deep undercover operation on site, so if you spot any familiar faces, keep your wits about you and don't blow their bloody cover, right? All the dirty details are attached. Oh, one tiny thing. The last lot I sent in there, Vamoose. So watch your back. All right then, go on, son. Get the V. Ta, butcher.
So, I guess just wish me luck. Let's hope I can get this Compound V. I went to get the V last night and it was intense. I got a lot of footage from the experience, so I'm just going to talk over it, explain to you what happened. I was there for about 40 minutes and it was a lot of fun. So I went with my friend Jack. This is my friend Jack. He told me to only show footage of him if it's funny. So sorry about that, Jack, that this footage isn't funny. So we took the train up there and we got to use the new Elizabeth line, which was very exciting. For everyone who isn't British, that means nothing to them. But there was a new tube line that opened like a week ago and I got to use it, which was fun. Oh, my eyes seem sad. Anyway, we showed up and the whole place was decked out with like Vought logos, and inside we could see posters of the superheroes. And we were standing outside for maybe 15 minutes as we waited for our slot to start with. I think we went with 8 other people. And we could just see blood on the window from the outside. And that's when we started to worry a little bit. The adrenaline started to kick in. We didn't know what this was going to be like. And it was definitely an interesting experience. So we went in and Ashley was there from the show. Different actress, of course. But she was swearing at us and getting annoyed with us. We were undercover as the cleaners and there was a big mess upstairs.
Yes, Sharon, that's exactly what I'm trying to fucking do, you fucking moron. Ah!
I'll just show you some of it now. It was horrific. And we basically had to go around and identify all the bodies. We literally had to get the lanyard off the corpses, get the name, and then tick them off of a list. And we were walking around, and then we heard some people starting to freak out. So we went in that direction, and there was a guy still dying in the bathroom, and he wasn't really telling us. He just said there was a superhero there who was attacking people, or someone with superpowers who was attacking people. So we took his card and we went into the security room, and we stayed in the security room for a bit. And I can't really show the footage of what happened next because it was very graphic. But Ashley, who was showing us around, went into another room. We watched her on the security cameras and she was saying about how the cleaning crew's all going to die because there's this superhero going about. And then she blew up. which wasn't nice. And so we went into the room where she blew up on, and we had to pick up her dismembered hand and use it to open the door. And we went down into the basement because we knew they were testing on people down there and they were locked up down there. So we went down and we met this scientist who said we'd help out with them. And she just said that we'd go and do the rounds with her. There were three superpowered beings downstairs that we met. The first one was Luminosity, I think he was called, and he just lit up and we didn't get a lot to do with him. The second one, I'm also not going to show any footage of, mostly for your benefit. He had a 10-meter long penis. And it moved. And the second person was a half dog, half lady, which we met. And we found out that the second guy's semen was corrosive. So we got his semen, put it in a syringe, and used it to erode the lock. So we managed to free the prisoners. And then we still had to get through this one door where the temp V was behind and it had a retinal scanner. So the dog lady went into a room and ripped out the scientist's eye, which we then used to get through the door. And through the door, there were the babies. You know, the babies from the show with the laser eyes. They were there in cribs. Before we got to the babies, though, we met this guy who said Billy Butcher had sent them there with his wife, and they were both captured and experimented on. His wife was the one that escaped and was killing everyone, and we were told to look out for her, grab some Compound V, and take it if we bump into her as a last resort. And this is also where they kept the Temp V. And we all helped ourselves to a vial, because the entire point of why we were there was to get some Temp V for Butcher. You guys probably haven't spotted it, but this entire time, I've had the Compound V behind me. Just here. I managed to keep some. Look at that. I'm going to drink this at some point. I don't know if that's a good idea or not. But we were given the Temp V, and I really want to drink it, but I think it might taste disgusting. I'll save that for the end of the video, because I'm not sure if I'm going to do it yet. But anyway, we got the Temp V, and we left this room where we met a security guard, and he said we need to go to the roof, and we'll be able to evacuate on the roof. Hopefully there's a helicopter there, and we'll be able to get away. So we were going up to the roof, and on the third floor, just before we got there, was this person who'd been running around killing everyone. So she was slowly approaching us while a security guard was creeping up behind her. They were trying to talk her down, but then a massive fight started. You know what? I'm just going to show you guys the fight. And then, just as you saw, the soup got rid of the two security guards, and then the most unexpected thing happened. We had a real-life member of the Seven show up, Black Noir.
second time today. Just piss off, get out of my face. Go! Go! Okay, everybody, just to be completely transparent, we have seen a few things here today that didn't happen, okay?
Sure. It was just incredible to watch because we really weren't expecting it. I was expecting kind of an escape room thing, and it was so much more immersive. So the attention to detail was crazy. You didn't really see in this, but in the offices there were just posters everywhere and signs everywhere of products. And then Black Noir was just so cool to see, and I got a photo with him. He was a nice guy. Could not shut him up though. He was a chatterbox, and it was just so much fun. So thank you again, Amazon Prime, for inviting me. Anyway, this morning, the first three episodes of the show was released, and I haven't watched them yet, so I'm going to go watch them now, and then I'll give you my thoughts, and then I'll drink the V. There'll be time codes down below if you don't want any spoilers about the show, and you just want to see me drink this weird liquid I was given. Okay, so the first three episodes of season three of The Boys is just bloody incredible. If you don't want any spoilers, and if you don't want to hear about my thoughts about that yet, you can just skip to the end where I will be probably drinking this. Homelander has fully lost his mind. And that's basically my roundup of the first three episodes. There are some incredible moments with Homelander, some really intimidating moments, and he is truly broken, and just some crazy stuff has happened to him. What I really loved about the start of this season was how they put these characters all together. So for the first two seasons of the show, the boys are hiding from the Seven and they never really mix, but they're in such different positions now and they've got such different relationships with each other that just putting them in a room and seeing what happens is just really fascinating to me. Just like the bit where Huey was walking back at the premiere at the very start of the show and he walked into Homelander. Stuff like that, small details, I'm like, yes, this is so interesting and so fascinating to me because now we've gotten to know these characters. Seeing how they evolve just makes it even better. And even in the first three episodes, they've pretty much given every main character a moment to shine. Apart from maybe Queen Maeve, but apart from that, they've given every single member of the Boys and every single member of Seven interesting character stuff to work with, especially Huey and Homelander and Billy. I find it really interesting that the Boys don't know about Billy taking Compound V yet, and I think it's really interesting that Huey's having this relationship with Victoria Newman, and he found out about her power so early on in the show was such a surprise to me, and I did really appreciate that. I've actually written down some highlights of the season so far here. So I've got Kimiko singing. I found that stuff really interesting. And we've seen this musical still in the trailer. So I'm really fascinated to see where this goes. Perhaps my favourite scene was the scene where the girl was on top of the building, was about to commit suicide, and then Homelander came to save her and Homelander killed her. I thought that was so interesting. And Homelander had a whole speech about how he is Jesus. Like, that just floored me. Just getting into this character's psyche like that was really interesting. I haven't said it yet, but all the stuff with Stormfront I found really interesting as well. How Stormfront was like laying there, Anakin Skywalker, and she said, "Oh yeah, no one struggles more than you, Homelander." Stuff like that I really enjoyed. And her freaking out about him not, you know, going for the Aryan race. Because he's not that bad, he's terrible. Homelander's birthday speech was also incredible. And while we're talking about big Homelander moments, him kissing Starlight, I kind of saw it coming, but it didn't make the scene any better. I really enjoyed Billy's relationship with Homelander's son, Ryan, until that moment at the end, but I'm looking forward to them patching it back up because I think, you know, that's where Billy's character's going now. So, what are my predictions for the season? I think a main character's gonna die. Before the season started, I said Queen Maeve, but the fact that she's barely been in it so far makes that less likely. I think this season is gonna end with Homelander winning. Because season one ended it with him winning, season two ended up with him losing, so then season three ends with him winning, four ends with him losing his mind and, you know, going crazy, and then season five is the final season of the show. That's my prediction of how stuff's going to play out. But how do I think the season's going to end specifically? I think they're going to find this weapon, they're going to try to use it on Homelander, it doesn't work, and then Homelander kills whoever was using it. And then I think that's how the season's going to end. But I cannot wait. I'll do a full review at the end because The Boys is my favourite show ever and these three episodes might just be the best three episodes of this show because stuff is going down. It is out of control. Anyway, I guess it's time I drink this. I have no idea if they're going to have made it nice or not, or, you know, I think this is going to be really anticlimactic no matter what. Can I get that lid off? Okay. Just have another look at that. This green liquid. It smells fruity. Okay. Ooh. Here's nothing. Let's hope I don't get superpowers. I don't know. That's like fruity mouthwash. It was alright. Let's hope it doesn't make me vom. Anyway. Thanks for watching. Please remember to like, comment, subscribe. Thanks again for Amazon Prime to invite me to the event. And go watch The Boys if you haven't already, because it's incredible. And I'll see you next time. Bye.